Ladies and gentlemen, this is Yu Wei Tong. I'm CEO of KBest, located in Taiwan. My background is microwave and wireless. I have about 35 years of expertise in microwave and wireless engineering. Today I have the topic GORA. And GORA is an advanced wireless technique for IoT and AIoT. Everybody is very familiar with two major categories based on bandwidth. You know broadband and narrowband. Broadband, everybody know every day with you, like Wi-Fi, like 4G, like 5G. They are broadband category. Another category is narrowband, and generally in narrowband category, there are four major solutions. One is Zigbee, two LoRa, three Sigfox, four is NB-IoT. And the solution 1, 2, 3 are used for private network, and NB-IoT is under public network. So because I think everybody learn broadband, 4G, 5G, and the construction of 4G and 5G is quite convenient and available. So I think there is no doubt that NB-IoT will be the dominant one in market. Let's talk about Zigbee and Sigfox. Now fewer and fewer systems are using Zigbee now as a result of some transmission bottleneck works. I think I don't mention too much about the bottleneck work. I think you can go to visit the website and you can learn everything. And Sigfox is also a very famous narrowband solution, but it faces a major bottleneck work, long latency as a result of quite a limited data rate. Although we talk about narrowband solution, but sometimes now many end device, different sensor, they also need higher data rate than before. Next one, we talk about LoRa. So far, more and more application are still using LoRa. However, very few people were satisfied with the performance of LoRa. The major problem of LoRa is high packet error rate. This will result some problem. First, it will have significant sensitivity degrading under wireless environment, and the performance will become poor when under interference. Maybe people will ask why you want to use LoRa. LoRa is a very cheap solution and a very friendly use, and still many people use them. But really, there are some problems when you are installing into real site application. I stress again, it is a high packet error rate. I think in digital communication, you need to receive many data. But when you receive the data, it's error bit. How can you translate the data into real and useful application? Let's talk about the public network, NB-IoT. Now this is the dominant one in market now. But there are some potential problems in using NB-IoT. First, longer latency. So the latency of NB-IoT is quite long. I think everybody is quite familiar about this one. Okay. The second is a higher power consumption. Okay. So the consumption, power consumption of NVLT is relatively higher than other narrowband solution. Oh. If their electrical power supply is quite available, it's no problem. Okay, NVLT is quite okay. However, in some site, when the power supply need to be by battery, I think the power consumption of NVLT will be a problem because it will, in short time, it will run out of the power of battery, okay? The third problem is the packet collision, okay? You know, NVLT is a public network, so I think the priority must be after your smartphone under 4G or 5G, okay? So in some area, when many people are using share the same base station, I think the NVLT, the latency will become longer and longer, okay? And four, the very high risk, I think the major risk is security, okay? I think it is common sense that all public network might be much more easier attacked by hike, okay? So, you know, now hike attack many big famous company recently, okay? So if your solution is by NVLT, I think the security might be a very high risk. Okay, now let's talk about Gorilla, okay? Okay. Okay, first, I highlight, Gorilla is an advanced new technology, okay? It is oriented from LoRa, okay? So, we use about 5 years, yeah, we do some spatial improvement, okay? The basic, we still use LoRa IC from Semtech, okay? Then we put some special software and we add external hardware, okay? Then some hardware will be controlled or programmed by software. So we call this is some special firmware, okay? So in short, okay, we use the same LoRa IC and externally we put software, firmware, and the hardware to significantly improve the performance of LoRa, okay? So the major improvement of LoRa, Gorilla over LoRa, okay? First, now the packet array, as I mentioned before, the major problem of LoRa is a high packet array, okay? So the first improvement of LoRa to become high performance Gorilla is the packet array is significantly improved, okay? For example, maybe in some environment, LoRa, the packet error rate may be 50 to 80%, but now Gorilla is just 1 to 5%, okay? And as I also mentioned before, if you use LoRa, your sensitivity might be degraded, okay? So now after improve and become Gorilla, then the sensitivity under non-line of sight transmission, it can be 20 dB better than LoRa, okay? For the non-line of sight, NLOS mean non-line of sight, that you cannot see each other, okay? And 20 dB, I think is a big jump, yeah? In wireless transmission, even I think 6 dB is a big difference. I think 20 dB is quite different, quite different, yeah. Okay, in real site testing, this is also under some non-line of sight environment, okay. LoRa and Aurora, in lab testing, sensitivity, in some condition, minus 20 dBm, minus 20 dBm. And the packet array, 1%, 1%. So in lab testing, not much difference. I think the sensitivity and packet array. So LoRa in lab testing is good enough, no problem. So everybody like to use this. But once put the device into outdoor to do wireless testing, I think you can get in some condition the LoRa sensitivity from minus 120 dBm degree to minus 97, okay? And the LoRa, it just from minus 120 dBm degree to minus 117 dBm, okay? So it is about 20%. LoRa is 20% better than LoRa, okay? And for the packet array, okay. So LoRa might be 60%, but for LoRa, it's just less than 3%, okay. In real-side testing, so you can see the significant difference between LoRa and LoRa. Okay, even LoRa, we have a different grade, maybe we have another. We have one of the LoRa, we mean high level, high level. We have some state of the art performance, okay. First, it can work up to basement, basement 3 or basement 4, okay. And it can penetrate metal box, and it can penetrate the earth up to 3 meters underground, okay. It can penetrate the forest up to 2 kilometers, okay. And it can link well across the sea up to 200 kilometers, okay. So I think you can see from 1 to 5, I think most of the transmission is beyond your imagination, okay. So so far, almost no solution can work up to basement 4, and it's very difficult to penetrate the metal box. It's very difficult going to underground, and it's very difficult going to forest, and it's very difficult across the sea up to 200 kilometers. And besides, LoRa owns the highest security against hike, okay? I think this is the best one. Okay, in some real site, I think for some lower end application, I don't put too much stress here. We say some high end application. First, in petrochemical and steel plant, okay, you know, all the construction are by steel, and the transmission is very, very difficult by wireless. Even you have underground, you are inside the tower, okay? So use LoRa, the transmission is quite available, and the packet array still very, very low, okay? And the LoRa can also use for electrical tower, okay? You know, electrical tower maybe in mountain area, in very far area. I think there are some different sensors besides the besides this electric tower, but it takes very much time for people to approach such tower. So they need wireless monitor. So by LoRa, now are the best performance under all narrowband solution. Okay. We have some SOS rescue system. Okay, maybe in mountain area, maybe like Africa area, when 4G and 5G is not convenient and available, I think for rescue, the SOC button, you can use Gora, okay? The very important application is for firemen, okay? So, you know, firemen go into, generally go into some unknown building with very bad environment, okay? So we can do SOS help, and we can transmit live sensor, we can learn the fireman, the position, and from the command car, we can send urgent command to the fireman, all by Gora, and to secure the life of the fireman. Okay, in industry application, okay, the Gora can put into metal, and you can monitor the transformer, the electric component to prevent it into bump, okay. Finally, in sea area, okay, you can see many from vessel, small port, I think generally they need a communication. But I think generally up the seashore up to 10 kilometers, I think all the transmission, all the public network is disconnected. Okay, so I think use Gora, I think all the transmission is the data, is the voice, then can be still connection quite good, quite well. Okay. Today, this is a simple introduction of Gora. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your listening. Okay, thank you.